I know some people still go to the mall. I'm kind of a mall guy. I love the mall. It was really the only thing to do when I was a kid growing up. They're definitely not as popular now as they used to be. I know that. It saddens me, but they're not. Not everyone shops at the mall. They shop online. The pandemic certainly didn't help things very much. A few places define the mall's fall from grace more than the Lloyd Center in Portland. It's now closed indefinitely after an electrical fire last week. It started in a generator room in the basement. No one was hurt, thankfully, but the mall says they don't know when they'll be able to reopen again, if ever. Lloyd Center was already struggling before this, with all of its main department stores leaving in recent years. But at one point, the mall, it was really the place to be in Portland. So here's Tracy Berry with a look back in the KGW vault.
1958 was a record building year for the Portland area.
KGW newsman Richard Ross delivered the headlines, and there were plenty. The Morrison Bridge opened, then the Interstate Bridge linking Portland to Vancouver, and to top it off, the Banfield Freeway was finished, laying out the perfect grid to bring people from far and wide to another development that broke ground in 58.
For the story on that, here's our news analyst, Tom McCall.
Industrial, commercial, and residential building worth a whopping $140 million got underway in Portland and vicinity during the past 12 months. The largest largest project of the lot was the $22 million Lloyd Center on Portland's Near East Side.
Lloyd Center, Portland's first shopping mall, would create quite a stir, opening just 2 years later on August 1st, 1960. An open-air wonder, 3 stories tall, boasting 100 stores and a skating rink with plenty of parking right in the city. Presidential candidate Richard Nixon, campaigning there, proclaimed it an example of America's greatness.
If you think the United States has stood still, who built the largest shopping center in the world? The Lloyd Shopping Center, right here.
Out of sight, out of mind. So the story goes, you forgot I exist. My broken heart knows. Out of sight, out of mind. You found someone new, but I can't change my love the way that you do. Forget if I could, but my heart is blind. You are gone out of sight, but not out of my mind.
You've arrived. To tell the complete history for the Lloyd Center, we must travel back in time further than we ever have before. Almost a century ago, an idea was conceived by Southern California oil giant Ralph B. Lloyd to build a self-sufficient shopping center that would include commerce, shopping, and residential offerings. But unfortunately, these plans were delayed almost 40 years due to the struggles of the Great Depression, World War II, and Portland's reluctance at the time to continue developing the area. Fast forward to August 1, 1960, and the Lloyd Center, a 100-store open-air shopping complex, came to fruition. It was the largest in the Pacific Northwest and claimed to be the largest in the country at the time, as several malls have. The mall would benefit from the recently completed Banfield Expressway and other developments at the time, and by the 60s, Portland was really off and running. Original anchors for the mall would include Meyer & Frank, Best's, Nordstrom Shoes, JCPenney, Woolworth, and J.J. Newberry, an impressive anchor lineup to say the least. And as a side note, if you have ever heard of the former Best chain, or if you never have, go and look them up. Their storefronts and designs were stuff of legend. The mall incurred its first expansion in 1972, adding six stores, a 50,000-square-foot Littman's, and an expanded JCPenney. Over the course of the next 20 years, the anchors would flip-flop several times due to company closures, changes, etc., as they often do. By 1987, however, the mall was showing its age, and while malls were at their peak in the terms of growth, it was clear Lloyd Center had to play catch-up. 1991 saw the mall convert to the traditional enclosed format and also added an expansive food court. The mall was rededicated in August of 91, just after the mall's 40th birthday, but their first sign of trouble would come 7 years later when Glimcher Realty Trust bought the mall for $167 million. More changes would come that same year as JCPenney would close to be replaced in an odd occurrence by Sears of all chains. Fading chain Newberry's would close in 2001, and Meyer and Frank would become Macy's in 2006. The mall was sold again in 2010, partially to Blackstone Real Estate, and then finished off to Cypress Equities in 2013. In 2014, Nordstrom closed at the mall as the slide continues. 2015 would see the start of the gradual transformation of the mall as a $50 million renovation would take place to make the mall more pedestrian-friendly in an attempt to capitalize on the new residential buildings coming up nearby. The following year, Sears would sell its space and then eventually close in 2018, followed up by Marshalls the following year. The closures continued as Macy's pulled out in the fall of 2020, and when Old Navy pulled out in early 21, no traditional anchor store remained at the mall. Lloyd Center would be foreclosed upon by KKR Real Estate in November of 21 due to delinquent payments on its $110 million debt loan. The mall today is best described as a business center that has an employee food court, a few shops remaining of the old mall heyday, and a large ice rink in the middle.
Thank you.
Hey everyone, Anthony here with Aces Adventures, and welcome back to another episode. I hope you guys are enjoying what you're seeing so far of the transforming Lloyd Center in the eastern portion of downtown of Portland, Oregon. As you can imagine, I live in the northeast, and this place is in the very, very far away Pacific Northwest. So when I had an opportunity to travel for work just recently here and had some spare time, of course, I had to go check out Lloyd Center. And what I'm going to do here is just talk for about a minute or so here and just give you my thoughts on the mall. And then you're going to see a pretty awesome old commercial for the mall. And then we're going to go down into the depths of the mall and check out the really creepy, just derelict underground, vast underground expansive parking garage this mall had. And you're also going to see some external shots of the mall as well. So this mall surprised me in the fact that portions of it look like a mall, portions of it have the old charm, portions of it have the 80s look, portions of it have the old, all the way back to the 50s and 60s, excuse me, with the door handles and the old office spaces. It's just really a mishmash of different types of places. But a very, very unique mall that is being transformed into more of a business center and less of a mall every day, so more of a community center than a mall. So I apologize for not being, you know, putting videos out as much as I have. Work has just been extremely crazy, but I promise you, as I have said before, this channel is going nowhere. And as soon as June hits, I will have some more availability during the later part of the week to get out and film some stuff. So I hope you guys are enjoying this video so far. And like I said, I've just been very, very busy with stuff, but this was such a cool place to visit and a very unique place to visit. And I'm hoping to get back out to the Pacific Northwest more here in the future. So here's a shot of the arcade coming up and this amazing vintage commercial. And then I'll probably be back at the end of the video with some final thoughts on the Lloyd Center.
Forsaken and remote lies the lonely suburban center, the crickets, cows, and the goat. But in the center of the city, in the middle of it all, the only center in the center of the city, Lloyd Center has it all.
Which one have
Say what? Nah. This is, dude, this is cool down here. Yeah, Century 3 has a part like this as well too. Richland. Yeah. This is awesome. Yeah, this is really awesome. Oh yeah, what is that? Oh really? Oh yeah, cool. Careful, garden. That's cool.
Hello.
Sweet. Over this way?
Yeah.
That's cool. Call tagged up the. Somebody had paintball and a speed sign. Yeah, this is. Yeah, this is like. I'm kind of glad you're with me. This is like sketch level, like. Oh, really? This person. That's all right. Is that,
Look at the broken glass and all the graffiti. Yeah, those are... This is what I live for, man. Like apocalyptic mall guts. Let's see what's up this stairway. Oh, yeah. Of course it does. What's up with these random fish? Well, there's the mall. This is how South Carolina is too, like that goes to the parking garage. There is a walker up on the ledge there. What the hell?
I want to thank everybody for watching today's episode. I know I have not been as active as of late, but I promise you there are more videos coming as we transition into the summer months. This is Anthony with Aces Adventures, and if you enjoy my content and appreciate the work that I put into these videos, I kindly ask that you do me three things. Follow me on Instagram at acesadventures1. Please leave a comment and a like. The more activity there is with this video, the more the algorithm likes it and the more YouTube pushes it out to more people. And lastly, if you enjoy my content, once again, please consider subscribing, because without my subscribers, there would be no Aces Adventures. I appreciate y'all watching this video and I hope you enjoyed it. And I just want to give one last little shout out to the gentleman that I spoke with in the park near Lloyd Center, who gave me some of his food that he was feeding the local squirrels. It's truly the relationships and the people that I've met through this journey that have made it all worth it. This is Anthony with Aces Adventures. I'll see you all in the next video.